played him a little bit, and that guy is definitely a wall. All right, let's see how this goes.
All right, opening up with the Flamingo mix-up, right into the low. Oh, I think he was going for a down 4-2 there, but doesn't matter. Gets the low option, and Joey Fury right now. Let's see if he's able to start the offense. Okay, down 4-2. Caught him out of the air. Did not get the full transition into a combo, but doesn't matter. And Iron Bryant not afraid to use that Flamingo low kick, that new move that Hwarang has.
Yeah.
Gets a trip every single time.
And Joey Fury definitely at a life deficit right now. Nice little parry here for Iron Bryant.
Oh.
But he drops the combo, gets the throw. Unhand me, sir. I don't know you. Goes for the throw again. Nice duck. And this is what we were talking about. Joey Fury did lose that round, but look how quick he reacted to that load just to make sure and even duck the throw.
Okay, Flamingo mix up canceling in his face.
And this is what I was talking about. Oh, rocket kick.
Yeah, went for the forward, forward, four, able to land. Here's the follow-up. What's he going to do? Running three there from Iron Bryan. And Iron Bryan with the pressure. Again, he's getting so much mileage out of these lows. Nice duck. Able to do the extension for the Parabellum kicks. Here comes Joey Fury. He's going to push for the Oki, looks like.
Oh, nice. Down 4-1-1. Hwarang in rage right now. Iron Bryan needs to be careful. But Joey Fury needs to be aware, too, because he can definitely go right into rage or...
Oh, he had a counter hit there. He could have went for the launch.
Nice. Down back one.
Oh, he landed the first few hits there. And that's going to... Oh, my goodness. Slow motion. Again, that Flamingo low knocking him down. And Iron Bryan, just like that, two rounds straight, kind of stole that one away.
Oh, debugger.
Goes for the mid there.
Nice. This is down 4-2.
Yeah, and Jack is such a good character in this iteration of the game. Aside from having very strong, just normal pokes, the inclusion of down forward 1-1 really helps his combo game overall.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Just down 2 to end it.
Really smart. Not going for too much there. Saw the back 3. Easy punish.
Nice duck under the Parabellum kicks again. Went for up 4-2. I don't think that's what he wanted.
And you see Joey Fury getting a little more comfortable in his defense right now.
Command throw right through the back 2.
Yeah, he's getting a lot more comfortable playing at the range as he's at right now. Nice jab to catch him out of there. Still nothing, no big conversions from Iron Bryant.
Yeah, and that's the first we've really seen Joey Fury go for the forward one elbow. Oh, no. Is that going to hit? No punish. What a bait. It's a volcano buster.
Up in this
Oh, that could be it. Oh, no. Here's a mix-up.
Oh, went for the throw. He
How did that whip?
Oh, my goodness. God.
Here we go. Hwarang looking for more parts for his bike, looking to dismantle Jack 7 even further.
Debug right out of the gate. Joey Fury, you can see a change already. Small punish right there. Could have got a little more. Down back one.
Yep. And someone asked just in the stream chat there, how does slow motion work anyway? So as far as I know, when both players have the potential to kill at the end of a round, slow motion can come into play when moves come out.
Yes.
But both moves have to come out simultaneously, obviously.
Yep, and potentially have death on the line. And as you can see here, Joey Fury definitely playing a little better this time around, being a lot more offensive. Actually going for a little more throws. I guess he sends an Iron Bryan. Is it either going to duck him or he's not going to break
him? Oh, he went for his big side step one. Here's the follow-up. What's he going to do with it? More pressure from Iron Bryan. Oh, again, that evasive punch.
Oh, nice. While standing one.
Hey, gets the wall again. Goes for the low. Here's a mix-up. What's he going to do?
Look at this offensive change right here by Joey Fury, doing a lot better this time around.
A little too slow on the punish
there. Back one, and Joey Fury is back in this right now. Two rounds up, second game.
And, you know, after that heartbreaking loss in that first match, Joey Fury able to hold it down. Going two straight rounds, and they're very dominant rounds, too. Not having, 1-1-3. I can't believe that landed. More mix-ups. This time going for a mid there. Oh, wow. I can't believe that hit. Big combo follow-up.
Nice.
You should get the wall.
The extension drops the combo. Down back one.
All right. Looking pretty good, but he gets a counter hit. He's going to close it out here. Joey Fury.
And that's going to be the round. Joey Fury comes back three rounds straight after that first match loss to Iron Bryan. And now they're tied one game apiece.
We'll see how that works out. But anyways, one match apiece. Iron Bryan versus Joey Fury. Here we go. Winner of this match will move on in the winner's bracket. Okay, so as a competitor right now, out of these two guys, who do you want to play against?
In all honesty, I've already lost to Iron Bryan, and I play Joey Fury in casuals. His defense is so good right now, so I'm not even sure. I'm actually just want to see what's going to happen because both of these players are really good.
Oh, I can't believe he got hit by that.
Counter hit.
No one gets hit by that. Holy crap. And Joey Fury going in.
Debugger. That rage drive debugger. Joey Fury
And again, if you guys are tuning in right now, you're watching Tekken 7 Faded Retribution Top 8 live from Canada Cup here in Toronto, Canada. Lots of love to the stream chat. I know you guys are watching. Me and Tasty Steve are going to be holding it down with the Wild Rising 1 there from Joey Fury. Goes into screw. Here's the follow-up.
Oh, went in for that throw.
Oh, wow. Interesting.
Nice power crush. Gets the low parry. See what he does right here. Nice. Nice extension right there.
Goes for the big boot kick, of course.
Nice duck right there. Oh, and we saw it again, man. That low giving so much mileage.
Super greedy there, going for two in a row. And that's going to end it here. Joey Fury right into the rage yard.
And two rounds straight. He's on his, what, fifth consecutive round that he just won in a row right now.
Joey Fury holding it down for upstate New York here. Let's see if he's able to close that out and move on into winner's finals. Oh, nice power crush.
The power crush.
That's a nice follow-up right there afterwards. Has excellent Oki after the sidestep 1+2. Here's the follow-up. What's he going to do?
And you see Iron Brian kind of taking a step back now.
Counter hit. Oh, but doesn't get a combo. Went for a bound there for some reason. Shades of tag two.
Nice. So that's going to take off a lot. And this is what I was talking about. Joey Fury definitely got a leg up right now because he has so much life. But that big launch right now, and Iron Bryant still back in it, brings it back, stops that round lead. Man, five rounds straight there for Joey Fury, and you get the nice interruption on rounds by Iron Bryant.
Yes, sir.
Oh, nice 4-1. That relaxed. And once again, Joey Fury already taking a life lead. Oh, get your ass up in this air, though.
Into the Volcano Buster. Here's the follow-up. Going to be a nice 50-50. What's going to go for? Deep bug. Live and die. Down 2-1 takes
that
it.
Will be that. Joey Fury moves on, and he'll be.
Oh, he does not know this?
The gimmicks.
Fake flip?
Yo, the tricky. The fakey gets the wall up. Lots of damage right out of the gate. That was an Akuma-like combo right there.
Yeah, Reno is going in hard. Oh, never mind. He's going to get hurt.
He doesn't have any meter, so he's still in good standing.
Yep.
Nice roll right there to get out of trouble. Back 1-2-1.
What a confirmed great stuff.
Pulco doesn't know. Pulco does not know.
You know, I bet you even though he blocked it, I bet you he still doesn't know how to punish 1-2-1.
Yeah.
He probably doesn't know to sidestep the third hit either. Oh, Reno went for the big screw there. He went for the extra damage. Okay, I think Reno knows how to deal with that, but I think he's letting Pulco do it just to kind of give him an option later on. That should end it right here.
Okay, one round apiece. And just like that, now he has 50% meter, so now you really have to be careful. A lot of hits are going to transition to a lot of damage. There's the throw break.
Oh, he was slightly off axis, so the throw whiffed.
Dude, Pulco does a really good job of resetting in the neutral.
Oh, the dragon punch. He's going to land it.
Lots of damage. And he ate hits after. So it's definitely going to take away a lot of damage. Still
teleport.
The...
No.
Oh, punish.
Punish. Nice. And he's going to close it out here. Oh, no. Very close. Oh, he don't know that either.
He don't know that. That's a 10 string, baby. He don't know that.
All right. Reno face 2-1. Has an opportunity here, but the demon flip throw. An excellent Oki for Akuma. Wow, the second hit. Goes for the spike. This is where all the tricks are supposed to come out.
And like I said, you have to remember, Law is a Tekken history character.
Wow.
Like, he has a lot of specific things that have been in the series for such a long time that I feel like that's why it's working. That's why it's throwing Pulco off. So he needs to be really careful. Nice block. Tries to go for the punish.
Oh, he extended all the way. And that kind of made him not be able to recover in time. But going to the final round here. And again, Pulco very dangerous because he has full meter. Two break on the throw, did not break the DSS. Oh my goodness.
Counter hit, EX, DP on wake up.
More pressure here. Great stuff, and Pulco now pushing towards the wall, but he's out of meter.
Doesn't matter, that's the mix-up. Gets out of it, wow, gets it.
Look at this, and that's gonna be close to it. One mix-up. Oh, he had an opportunity there.
Oh.
Air Tatsu EX style.
Now we've seen Pulco. Keep that in mind.
All right, here we go.
Game two. And I feel like Dragon Slide will really do a lot of work in this matchup.
Oh, yeah. And who knows? Does Pulco even know how to punish the Dragon Slide properly?
Nah, it's going to get a combo off of that. Nice. Kind of small punish right there. If he would have waited for him to land, would have been able to do a lot more. Wild Rising 1, punch parry.
Punish there.
Learning.
I would keep doing it.
Oh, trying to go for like the old school tech. Nice. And it beats the adopted.
This is where he's scary. He does that meter.
That's what I was talking about. You saw him go for the air tattoo. Low three. Ah. He's always going to go for that. He has no choice, and he had meter. So even if you blocked it, he would have to either commit to DP or the hurricane kick, which you would have launched.
Here comes Reno. Oh, but again, the down three from Akuma. Oh, that's a big launch. He should be able to get towards the wall, too. One more mix-up. Oh, nice. Get out of dodge. Oh, he caught him. Ugh, Tech Roll City.
Yeah, the longer the juggle, the harder it is for it to land. But the shorter it is, it gets more and more ambiguous.
Let's see if Reno is able to make a comeback here. He's down two rounds. Not looking good. But Puko opting to style on him right now. Oh, he doesn't know it. Okay.
Nice.
He should be able to get a nice Oki mix. Oh, nice teleport.
Oh, runs right into that right kick hurricane. Oh, tries to go for Wild Rising 2. Oh. No punish.
Oh, that's going
to
be it. And Puko moving on to winner's final. Yeah. No, it's just 2 out of 3. Okay. Harris versus Neo Russell.
Oh, wow. We got the life bar glitch.
Okay. Follow up. Nice whip punish. Wow, Eris was ready for that. Hey. Oh, and he gets the wall this time. Goes for the stomp. Oh, nice roll.
We saw yesterday, Eris was not too on with his combos. Well, not yesterday, but Friday.
He was definitely off when it came to combos.
We saw him play a lot, so I'm pretty sure he's got a nice handle on what he should be doing right now.
All right, now Neo Russell staying alive. He got really lucky with there, not getting the Oki on the stomp. But here we go, the follow-up.
And look how much he's turtling. This is really smart. Neo Russell likes to party. So I feel like Eris being a natural turtler is also going to help in the fact that like you say, I think this is a bad matchup for Paul.
Oh, caught him backdashing.
Uh-oh. Oh, nice break on the throw. Nice.
Oh Devil Man. This is the party that we were talking about. Are you ready for it? Oh,
get off
normal
me.
Grab.
Oh, that 4-1's going to win. Oh, wow. Okay, okay.
And that was very nice. So Eris has been playing very spacing heavy and also very compact. No punish there from Neo Russell. Okay, goes for the wall rising 4. Here comes Eris. Eris partying on his own.
Yo, the
10-string city.
Ooh, oh, backswing blow.
And he's going to get the wall. Yep. He goes for the option again.
Went for the stomp. Nice down 4 there to stop that last hit. Nice body check down 12 to get out of that corner. Oh, wow, standing 4. And you got to remember, man, Eris comes from a place where he used to play Chet a lot. Nice pause there.
True.
You know, so he's definitely going to react to a lot of this. I don't know if Neo Russell has a counter pick or not, but, ooh, nice counter hit down 4-2 right there.
Here's a follow-up. What's he going to go for? Demo, man. Nice clean combo, but what's he going to do afterwards? Wow,
nice.
The get-up kick into the transition.
Dragon off one of the only characters in the roster anymore with an option like that off a knockdown.
All right. And, again, look at Eris' spacing just now, looking for that opening. And every single time Neo Russell has tried his approach with the flash elbow, opting to get some damage here, but here comes a conversion.
Oh, nice.
Now, this natural combo this time. No duck there.
Oh, get off of me. This time gets the throw. Not over yet. Eris up 2 rounds, and that's a really smart go-to move to go to. Want to go to that blatant low, but it has such good range, you know?
Yeah, nice quarter circle back 3. Here's a follow. Ooh, he jabs him right between it. They switch positions.
Oh, nice slide. Shredder kicks. Nice punish. Tries to go for that one breaker throw. That was really smart. Ducks the 4-4-2-1. Gets the counter hit lunch.
You know, and that's the thing. Every time he was trying to get in, he was going for the. Oh no! That's not what he wanted. Good block there from Neo Russell. No punish. Again, he's been going for the 4-4-2-2 cancel, but unable to get anything out of it.
Run up, down, 2, and Eris takes it. Gets a nice little break.
Works out.
Oh, nice counter 1-2-1.
Oh, again.
And look at the spacing from Eris right now.
Eris is going in now. Okay, here we go. Follow up. What's he going to do? And Eris keeping him honest there.
And there's that 10-string starter again and scored quite a few hits with it.
Oh, there's no mix-up there. Oh, nice stutter.
That's a demo, man. And he,
and he's going to close it out. Oh, he drops the combo.
And now Neo Russell is playing the game he's supposed to play with Paul. He's doing a really good job of mixing up on wake up after knockdown.
Oh, no punish.
Oh, as well as committing to strings that you normally don't commit to as Paul because you don't want him to get a punish. Drops the combo again. Nice down 12. Uh-oh, nice. Wild Rising 1-4. Oh, hits the counter hit. Going to get a small combo.
And the wall, though.
Oh, nice awareness right there to go for that full count, full crush down 4-3. Special animation there from Dragunov.
Okay, oh. Nice duck again. This time getting another punish. Eight.
Oh, not expecting Neil Russell to go for those lows on wake up to get that combo. That oh God.
And there's a big punish there on the Death Fist. One of the things that Paul cannot really do in this matchup. Back to shoulder.
Whoa, right now, and Eris is on round point. Well, Matt set point, actually.
Eris looking to take this. Let's see what happens. Nice.
Oh, nice up 4-4. Nice stomp. Can't lay on the ground, Russell. You got to get up. Oh, my God, and now he's just opening up the bag. Getting all the throws, all the shenaniganery. Demo man from Neil Russell.
And
he's
not
out of the shit.
He does have rage as well, so you can't count out Paul. Every time he has rage, he has an opportunity. Oh, up 4-3.
Three. Oh, Wild Rising 1-4 again. Down 3 to take it. And that.
All right, here we go. No, here we don't go.
Oh, it's a man. Button check. Ooh. Why are you checking your buttons? You show up late and then you button
yeah,
check.
Yeah, I know. Get rid of him. So how's everything going so far? I'm hearing popping in the headphones. Does that mean their headphones online are getting popping?
I don't know.
Okay, good.
Are
okay.
We good?
Okay. All right. So we're going to get this on the way here. Thanks very much for joining us. I have to say, day 3 of Canada Cup, this is one of the better tournaments I've been to all year. The air conditioning in the room, everything went smooth.
We didn't get a chance to catch up yesterday or talk at all. How
yeah.
did you enjoy the local cuisine?
It was good. I had a poutine place. Some people were saying it's not like you're right about that. He's got good ways to deal with highs. Oh, yeah.
Counter hit city.
And this is going to be big damage.
Steve was just talking about how he implemented that into his repertoire lately.
Yeah.
It's not a move that he uses traditionally.
Okay.
But it's such a good option against Mishima.
Oh, he got lucky man. With that mid. Oh, man.
He almost broke his leg.
What a crouch. It may not kill, but there is a rage drive. Yeah, I think it's going to kill
Yeah,
that.
The laser does so much damage. Pew, pew, pew.
Yeah, the rage drive is what did it there. Nice work. Not drive, art. Rage art.
Yeah, and one of the best, I think, gaming metas with the Mishimas, especially if you're using Kazuya, is to duck because his Wild Rising 1-2 is so fast.
So strong, yeah. Nice electric on point. This time he's ready for the forward 1. Elbow. Man, the offense from Onigen. Give me that leg.
Never try that again.
Give me that leg. I'm taking it home with me.
Thanks for the donation.
Backing up, facing.
Oh, nice. Able to get right under the Godfist.
South of the border. That's another tool that's good for Godfist. Oh, man. Wow, he's ready.
And but Kazuya is one of the few characters that can actually launch punish that gut punch from King.
Oh, man.
But right now, in rage. Oh, no,
that's
be careful.
Not gonna cut it.
And the ghetto mix-up the Mishimas have when they block or see anything whiff, they can always go for a mid or the health speed.
Dangerous low, but very risky. Okay, spacing from Steve, but he needs to figure out how. Oh, man.
Thanks for eating.
Thanks for eating?
Yeah. Can't eat those electrics. Oh, again!
Oh, my God. He's hungry. It's all you can eat.
Yeah, it's a buffet.
Oh, and I like the varied Okazumi there.
Yeah, smorgasbord of Godfist.
He's keeping Steve guessing. No duck on that. No punish as well.
Oh, man. He's waiting again. Yeah, looks
he's hatching an egg. He's got a juicy lead. Sitting ugly.
Crouching Jaguar hitting Kazuya. Yeah, oh, my God.
Wow. 3-0, 1-4 into down 4-2.
Yeah.
That's gone?
The full crazy version that he does, yeah.
Oh, okay.
I mean, that thing was kind of ridiculous.
Yeah. Well, it works in this version. It is ridiculous.
Yep.
Man, look at this. Is more like it. A little more patience. That's what I'd like to see.
Oh, okay. Put the brakes on.
Down 4, backing up. He's getting pushed to the wall slowly, though, but he is cautious about those electrics. The keep out has really been. There's another one. Good block. Okay.
Normal throws.
And if the position change.
If I remember right, normal throws were working wonders against Onigen at SCR.
Oh, and he's got one of his own. Okay, that is safe.
Oh.
On a shallow block. You have to be ready for that. Hell sweep. One last chance for Steve. Oh, that's not going to do it. The crowd just kind of groaned a little bit.
Yeah, you got this cool cape on, but you're not cool at all.
No. Snap, not at all?
Not at all. You can't throw out rage drives
like
that.
That was a nice throw right there.
Oh, last hit.
Stature kick. Offense, stature kick. Punishable, okay. There you go. Bringing it back. Nice one. Giant swing. Yeah, you better attack this.
Might hit the wall.
Oh. A bit far away. Oh, the whip, but nothing for it. And uh-oh.
Here we go. Party time.
Another one, and he knew about it. There's the hop kick. This should kill.
Oh, he had opportunity.
Done a rage drive.
He could have done the rage art. Yeah.
Okay, all right. He didn't quite use his resource there, but he pulled through anyway. Onishin. He made him bleed his own blood. First round for Steve. The poke. I like the returning fire there with the poke.
All right, now Steve looking again with that spacing.
Oh, too slow.
Going for that gut punch again. But right now, Onishin pushing him towards the wall. This is a dangerous position to be in.
Wow, hitting the brakes. Oh, man. Tekken tag one.
And the follow-up. What's going to happen?
Oh, no. Wrong punish. Not that punish. Ooh, okay. Oh, no. What is he? Aeris?
Yes.
That was the Aeris combo.
Yes.
Boom, boom.
One more mix-up. What's going to happen? Oh, he went for standing four.
Oh, falling apart. He needs to keep it together. That was an input error. Input round bug. Four. He looked down at his stick. Not happy about it.
Onigen one round away.
Get off. Oh, mistake. Electric. I feel like anytime a Mishima player makes any kind of input mistake, they do an electric to limber up.
Like, let me cancel that out real quick.
Erase the pass. Oh, the hell sweep again. He's so brave with those hell sweeps. Oh, almost converting off that. Oh!
The classic. He's going to push him towards the wall, too. This is going to hurt big time.
Yeah,
oh,
dead.
My goodness. Ow. And we were just talking about that.
Down one. And already picking apart Iron Bryan. Gets hit with the counter hit. 1-2-1. Oh, we saw him go through. This is one of his go-tos, actually. And I was talking to Iron Bryan last night. He was saying, like, he didn't expect to even, like, make it out of pools.
Wow. And look at him now.
Right.
What a whiff punish. That was amazing. So Iron Bryan right now taking that first round. Aeris is going to have to do some work. Back 1-2. Follow downstairs. Nice. Able to get some kind of extra damage out of it.
Oh, get up 3. Oh, nice. Up 4-4. Nice. Confirm. Gets the combo. Ground break. Really smart.
Ooh. Ouch. Oh, your
up
toes.
Yeah.
Got to protect the feet.
Nice pressure right there from Aeris.
Hopefully the volume's okay and you guys can hear as well.
Nice. Man, that low is a problem. Nice. Gets the nip up. Nice. Confirm. Not going to get a lot of damage because of the scaling. Oh, nice backswing blow. Finds a hit. Nice wall carry going to get right here. Ugh, you don't get up, I stop. Running two.
Going again for that follow-up. This is good stuff so far.
Oh, nice. Down back four. Full crouch down 4-4. Nice.
And Aeris right now, one round away from taking this first match. We're at the bottom floor here for Garden Realm.
Yeah, Aeris made quick work of those stages.
Yeah, he was like not dealing with it. Especially a high damage character like Warang.
Nice.
Wow. Aeris doing work right now. Fire him off. Here we go. Oh, he knows. Aeris partying maybe a little bit too hard. Warang has an opportunity here. Rage drive whiffs. And that's going to be it. Aeris takes that first match.
One of the situations.
All right, here we go. Nice block there. Sidestep 4. And Iron Bryan nice. Starting off with some Flamingo mix-ups, changing kind of his playstyle here early on.
Oh, nice. Backswing blow again. Nice bait out right there.
And this gonna is
going to
hurt big
no.
time.
Ooh. Go for the up 4-3 to get that wall splat again. While standing 4 to take it. And Aeris just going, he's like in autopilot right now. Not playing too crazy.
Oh, I'm not sure why he went for that. I mean, he could have had way more damage there. Oh, caught him out of the air. Oh, he didn't go downstairs. He had way more damage. Potential. Perfect. Wow. Doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
Holy
it's
crap.
Perfect. He's like, he could have did all this damage. He's like, I don't really. Perfect.
Don't need it. I'll say, oh, man, wall rising too. Follow him. What's he going to do? Slam City? No.
Oh, nice. Jump over low. The special.
Air is seemingly on cruise control, though.
Yeah.
Very comfortable in the matchup so far. No punish, but there's a normal throw downstairs. Here's a follow-up. Oh, does not get the combo.
Oh, wow. Why is it
and again, Aris. He should be able to close it out here. One more hit. Oh, he dropped it.
Nice. Full crouch down three.
Good old American reset. Two rounds to one.
Set point for Aris right now.
Ooh, second hit. They trade blows in favor of Warung, of course. Oh, no punish again. Went for the Parabellum kicks. Here comes a nice cancel.
Went for the low throw right there.
And the follow-up. Look at the sidestep there. Great stuff.
Got him again. And while Rising 2 caught him ducking. Breaks the floor this time.
He should be able to get the Rage Guard here. Oh, no. Doesn't get it. Misses the Rage Drive.
Nice block. All of the Rage Drive. That means he didn't take any damage, even from that low that does not combo. But he still loses the round. And Iron Bryan not out of this yet.
Final round here. Let's see if Iron Bryan's able to take it and tie it up. Or will Aris go all the way? What a sidestep into the launch.
Sidestep two gets the eye poke. Three again.
Got him again. Reset the situation, maybe. Oh, that might be it. He
drops it. Wild Rising 4. And he's not going to break that throw. And that's going to be that. And Aris makes quick work of Iron Bryan. Farino face because only Jim BB. So let's go.
All right, goes for the low there. A nice sidestep hop kick. And Reno face on the scoreboard.
Oh, so much damage.
Looking at, that's going to hurt big time.
Much damage.
Got the Cali roll out of it. Working on a perfect here.
Down.
Wow.
And just abusing Oni Jin.
That girl working it. So the crowd approves. Sidestep four into the Cali roll again. Look at this big damage here. I thought he got greedy there. Oh, and he doesn't know how to block it.
Good stuff. He has two variations. He has like low,
high, mid, low. And then she can also extend it with the forward spring kick too. And then she has the low version. Okay, nice. Gets the launch. Gonna get the wall again.
Dropped it. Oh, no punish.
Oh, that was a good duck on the 2-2, but 2-3 comes out.
Gets right out of range. Goes for a guy fist right there. Gets that combo. So look at this. Oh, my God.
Mix up city right after two. It puts Kazuya in such an advantageous Oki mix up. Oh, my goodness. That roll is so scary.
Gets the hop kick again. That should be the round. Oh, wow. And three rounds straight.
Fight. And lucky Chloe opening up the round with some back dashing. The second hit doesn't land, but nice health sweep pops in there from Onijin.
Only Jin a little more active this round. Oh.
Good sidestep.
Nice sidestep. Gets the back turn.
Damn, what do you do in that situation?
I just would have went for Hell Sweep.
Follow up. What's going to happen?
And that turn.
Reverse hop kick.
Big hit on the ground. Nice block. Gets the down for a two. Goes for double Hell Sweep. Yo, break dancing girls. Let's go. While standing, 4-4 tsunami kicks to take it. In a 28-second round, 28 seconds left on the clock, and Onijin is really good at waiting. As you can see, like, I noticed firsthand that he definitely likes to take the pace to a slower, more controlled. But when he gets those hits, he definitely makes them count.
All right, here's the push. Right now, so scary. One for the standing three. 3-4, second hit lands, but unable to get a combo. Reno face. You can tell Onijin's not feeling comfortable with the matchup because he's letting Reno face take initiative. My goodness, on the offense.
That's gonna hit,
and that's gonna kill.
Is it gonna kill?
It should kill.
Boom.
He didn't even use the Jess Frame version.
Yeah.
Which is, I mean, it's kind of hard to do. It's like a 5-hit Jess Frame.
Nice. Onijin deciding getting out of there. I don't know how much I agree with that. Gets the sidestep this time. No punish.
Second hit. Here's the combo, and he's going to get the wall, too. Never mind. Drops it. Normal throw, and normal throws have been working against Onijin. Wow, look at the sidesteps here.
Nice gotcha. That electric. I was waiting for it. Nice damage.
And the wall now. Bad positioning. Gotta get out of there. Power crush.
No break on the stone head. Down back four.
Is that gonna hit?
No, he's gonna block.
Oh, and a quick punish while rising 4-4.
He's gone to it too many times. Oni Jin is noticing it now. Nice dancing. I like it.
Now, what kind of pressure is Reno Face going to go with here? Oh, goes for the low. Now it's going to be a mini combo here. What's he going to do? 50-50. Oh.
Oh, here's the counter here.
This is going to hurt.
Oh, man.
And that's a move that he can pressure with as well, the 4-4-3. The big kick. Oh, into the low.
It goes right back to the low.
Now, Reno Face one round away from moving on, or Oni Jin might tie it up. We'll see.
Let's the string rip this time. Tries to punish that last hit. No avail. Goes for the double heel sweep.
Okay, what's going to happen? Someone's going to have to make a move here.
Yo, this song, though. That's all I care about is hearing this song. Only 33 seconds left on the clock, Gabe. You're right. Something's going to happen.
The choir's turning up. Oh, nice sidestep into the God Fist. Big, Oni Jin drops it, but right into the throw. Oh, it puts the brakes
nice
on
this cancel.
Time. No time left. You're going to have to do something.
Yeah, Oni Jin definitely has a definitive life lead at this point.
What's he doing? There's no time.
Yeah, he's not going to be able to come back from this. There's nothing he can do about this.
Oh, this is going to hurt. He's going to take the lead. Oh, not enough time.
Much like Ling, you know, definitely can get under your skin by being annoying. But Kazuya can definitely be annoying as well.
And I like what Oni Jin's doing here. He's taking control of the opening round here. Oh, and now chasing him down with the hell sweep.
And we've seen him do this at SCR. He's definitely comfortable with committing to the double hell sweep to get that knockdown, get a little more pressure. Tries to sidestep, gets hit. Oh, wow.
But she has rage, too. He's going to have to be careful. She's going to be pumping out the extra damage. And if she hits you with this back turn stuff. Oh, no. Is he going to do cancel? No, he just goes for the quick end. Look at that damage, too. That was a ton of damage there.
Oh.
Wow. He took him to the skies, and that is a mid. Safe mid.
Yo, do you want to build a snowman? I'm just saying, man. Yeah, he's stuck her in the dirt. Ugh. Nice down 4-1-2. Nice down 4-4.
Well, players looking for that opening. Whips the Godfist there. Okay. And the follow-up, what's he going to do?
Oh. Oh, nice jab out of there. Nice confirm. Nice chunk of damage. Nice way to get the offense started. Gets that big down 4-2 counter hit. Oh, wow. That's going to kill. Yeah, I don't think Skeleton's going to stop that from killing.
Yeah. Oh, the laser not doing enough damage. Did not get caught by the delay, but... And I don't like seeing the rage drive used like that. You can't use it as a panic tool. Bro. Gotta be careful. I mean.
Oh, down 4-2. And Oni Jin now has his groove. Crazy life lead and the round lead. He finds that big electric. And right now, Reno Face goes in the rage. That's how you know his life is low.
He has a chance. I mean, he has rage, but it's gonna be very difficult here.
Oh, nice punish. Finishes the string. Now definitely in kill range. If he can get, he needs to be really careful. 30 seconds left. We don't want to see what happened last time.
Oh, he's going to get him here. That's going to be it.
Oh, Reno Face not out of this yet. Round four. And this time, watching the clock, because that definitely cost him a round. Well, a match last time.
There we go. Lucky Chloe looking for an opportunity to get in. I think this might be the only new character that we have in the top eight is Lucky Chloe. Well, other than Akuma, of course. Oh, second in. Oh, went for the punisher. That was the right thing to do.
Oh, fishing for that down 4-2 and while rising 2. Finds ahead. It's going to do a lot of damage. And Oni Jin once again poised to take this set with this round. Oh, no sidestep this time. Goes right for Hell Sweep. And hits the low. Oni Jin.
All right, here we go. They're gonna start off. Nice down back two to open it up. But Joey Fury gets swept early on. Oh, the back one pressure.
Round three.
1-1. Oh, that's counter hit.
Oh, down back two with trades. Joey Fury still in this. Ryan can take away a lot of damage in a short amount of time. Wow, crouching two to keep him honest while rising 4-4.
Well, it was interesting. I wonder why Joey Fury was poking 3-3. Of course, Poku able to crush it there with a down two. Maybe he was trying to do a shortcut dragon punch, I'm not sure.
Oh, wow, rising three, that big knee. Oh, nice. He's going to hurt it.
Oh, he goes right under the demon flip.
Nice, using that jab to get under there. Nice block.
Oh, he doesn't go for the jet upper. But it doesn't matter. Hey, Joey Fury on the scoreboard. One round apiece. Oh, he spiked him out of the air. Hit him with an orbital. Oh, they trade.
And look at how slow Joey Fury is playing.
He went for the snaking. Okay, and here comes Puka with a big combo.
Finds a hit. I was going to be able to get a little confirm off of this. Oh, committed a little too hard. Nice realignment right there by Funko. Oh, nice. Text right at the end. Avoids that down three. Of course.
Dragon punch.
Of course he's going to do it. Yo, Infiltration is on the stage pumping up Funko right now.
He has half a Team Korea over there. Okay. All right, good stuff there. Joey Fury able to push towards the wall. Oh, nice. Gets up with the 4-4. Mix up. What's he going to do? But he has full meter. Joey Fury's going to have to be careful.
Oh, nice. Again, throw break. Runs into the down four. Goes for orbital heel versus the dive kick. Does not work out.
Oh, my God. That was so sick. Oh, Funko. We'll see. Again, this is 3 out of 5, so Joey Fury does have some room here.
Debugger on the whip. Running down three. He can set the pace right now. That's what's so good about Jack 7. Like, he can get those hits and start the pace just by making sure you don't do anything.
Yeah, but the X Factor, of course, is Akuma can jump and beat out
like
a lot
of
up. But this time, Joey Fury is snatching him out of the air. Okay, goes for a 2-1 punish. Boy, good stuff there from Funko. He's just back downstairs.
Kill.
Yep. Heavy Tatsu. Oh, man. The conversion here. Look at this combo.
Oh, my God.
And just look at the pressure from Funko. Everything working out in his favor, of course.
Oh. Nice rocket kick.
What a
down for a 2-1. Jab out of the air again, just like I said, 1.
Oh, he's gonna get the launch.
Nice. Down 4-1-1. Get that new extension. Floor break. What's he gonna do? Rocket kick?
Oh, he went for 4-4-1 there, but unable to do it early on. Okay. Nice. Follow up.
Oh, tries to get that down 4-1.
Gotta respect it.
Simple punish. Take the round. Don't get too greedy. Joey Fury still in there.
But Funko now sitting on almost full meter. Oh, no. This is going to hurt. Gets the wall as well. Doesn't get the full wall squad, though, but it doesn't matter.
Oh.
And here's a free follow-up. Oh, man. Funko's going to take this. Oh, misses the last hit. Interesting.
Uh-oh. He still got a chance. Rage drive. Oh.
You can't deal with the jump-ins. It's really hard. All right, down 4-3, opening it up. Here comes the low from Joey Fury. Now, Joey Fury looking to apply the pressure here.
Nice committing to lows right there. Able to take around 45% just on those lows alone, and he's going to get the wall. Oh! Oh, rocket kick. Right, nice range right there to do it. Not able to get a punish, even though really close to the wall. Hops over the debugger. Nice duck. No punish. Multiple
chances. The punishes are coming down. What's going on? You can't whiff two dragon punches like that. Oh, my goodness.
Okay. Oh, man. Whoa, Funko. This is the most confident we've seen Funko.
Especially now. He has full meter. Oh, this is going to hurt. He dropped the combo. That was really weird. Uh-oh. Shoulder. No, goes for the mix. You got to respect it all the time.
Nice.
Hey,
nice. Down
Joey
back one.
Fury. Gameplay. Fight. Oh, no. This is the scary Puka. When he starts going for those sweeps,
yep.
That's when you know. Oh, he gets a free launch after that.
But Joey is one of those players. He's going to space it out. Like, his defense is so good that he's going to try to backdash and get those punishes at that range. And he's also checking. So he's not giving Puka enough time to actually, like, push on his offense.
Yeah, that was nice there. He was able to shoulder check. Oh, good stuff so far. Everything working out.
Down back one.
Joey Fury controlling the match right now. There's a jump in. Got to be ready for those.
I'm going to get a big combo right here. Floor break. Yep. Go through. No, DP. Oh, man. Oh,
wow. Look at all that stuff. But now back to the wall. Uh-oh, here comes Joey Fury.
Oh.
Just beats out the mix-up totally.
Fires a hit. Not able to confirm anything. Oh.
Oh, he doesn't get the launch. That was guaranteed.
Get your ass in this earth. Oh, nice Volcano Buster.
Oh, he could have gone for the Rage Art.
And he dropped the combo and eats a counter hit down four. Oh, he could have just did Rage Art after the run under two. Oh, my God.
He definitely had an opportunity there. That probably could have killed as well. Okay. Extends the low kick there.
And Joey is so comfortable in staying at that range where he can obviously be tripped or even hit by down three into a combo. And he's still just staying there. Gets the ground break.
Again with the Volcano throw.
Oh.
Or is he just... Don't stay on the floor.
Oh, my God. Down three. No, but you have to be careful, man. Like, a lot of people are saying, why didn't you tech? Why didn't you do this?
Yeah.
You have to remember, there's a lot of situations where Puka still has options.
And nice, you know, one of the things I've noticed is Puka, usually when he breaks those, he'll hit 1+2. The Volcano Buster is not, oh my goodness, lit him up there. Oh, wow. And if there was a dizzy state in this game, Jack would be dizzy right now. Oh, again, do it again. That was a nasty combo.
That was so dirty.
And again, a lot on the line here in this matchup. 3 out of 5, but this is going to be for the lead into the demon flip.
That's what I'm talking about. Gets it down 4-2, not able to convert to anything. And once again, there's a whip punisher. Like I said before, Joey Fury definitely comfortable at the range where Puka can get so much started.
Uh-oh, here we go. He has the meter, but he didn't cancel that time.
Down four, puts him back in it. Nice backup right there, still in range. Down three again. Nice punish. You should have let him land. He would have been able to get a full combo. Oh.
Oh, this is going to hurt big time.
Oh man.
Show the lead, 2-1. This is winner's finals, 3 out of 5. Oh, the jump in, of course.
Down four, 2-1. Down four, 1-2, I'm sorry.
Oh, he knows it. He knows it. Running one follow-up, and again, Puka running right at him.
Oh, gets the jump in into the 1-2. First round, last potential game of this winner's final set. Fight. And now he's just waiting too late to check right now. Oh, gets the down 4-2 off of the dash. Joey Fury not out of this.
Looking for an opening, and look at that cancel there on the focus.
Oh. And look at that range he's playing. I like it. Puka, I was about to say, not going to fireballs.
Oh, he went for it.
Nice. This could be the round.
He didn't go for the rage art.
Oh,
and
my
And Joey Fury
God.
Eating the super. I think he tried to jump. He probably thought it was the demon there. Oh, man. That was unfortunate.
And we see Puka with that wry smile on his face.
The crowd cheering Duck for the second hit. Oh, big
nice.
Launch.
Down 4-2, full punish right now.
The other way.
Nice, I like Joy Fury just getting out of there. Testing with one hit of Wild Rising 1. Oh. Oh, wow. Nice backup there by Joy Fury. And that defense coming into play, and he can definitely take it right now.
Ooh, down 4-4 takes it.
Oh, no, whip punish, nonetheless.
Yeah, Joey Fury staying alive here. But hit him with the punch this time, able to beat out the jab.
Oh, Wild Rising 2 canceling the demon flip. And this third potential, last round, not looking too good for Joey Fury. Finds a couple hits.
Uh-oh, this is big damage.
Oh,
that's it.
That's going to be
and
that.
Secret Zoni Jin. Fight.
Right,
okay, second hit. Okay, goes for the easy follow-up. Doesn't want to go for the water edge before. And Aeris right now controlling the round.
And Aeris is going in, but look at the defense by Onigen right now. Double hill sweep. You've seen him go for it before. I'm pretty sure Aeris is taking note of it. Oh, wow.
Man,
and he's going to finish these streaks. Run up, down, too. And that's where Onigen likes to, like, work. Like, he wants you to hit a button in between those strings so he can slide an electric in there. And Aeris not taking the bait. Runs up down two just in case it is an electric. He's going to get evaded. But you can if you whip right in front of his face. Nice carry.
Yep. Very nice carry there. But follow up here from Aeris. He's going to get a mini juggle of his own. And Aeris is going to have to be careful too because he's been getting a lot of those down twos. Down two is block punishable from Kazuya.
Yo, the bar fight. So much damage.
Oh,
back two.
He got up the wrong way there. Aeris, two rounds straight.
A quick two rounds for Aeris. And Aeris is seemingly not afraid of these electrics at all. L sweep.
Nice L sweep there.
Oh, down 4-2, big counter hand. Down 4-1-4 to get the tail spin. Trying to get that corner carry. Tsunami kicks, hits clean. Oh, while rising 12. Down 2.
Oh, he could have had a combo follow up there.
Oh, backswing blowing. That's going to be the first match. Loser semi. This is first of three, right?
No, it's two out of three. All right, here we go.
Oh, nice block on the hail sweep.
Uh-huh. Gets a big punish, and here's a follow-up going for the big damage.
Oh, nice slide, and he's safe. Oh, commando roll up 4-4. Dude,
wow.
Onigen is
Aeris
getting hit
going
with everything.
Hard.
Working on a perfect right now. Goes for the low parry feint into another low. Oh, wow. And Onigen just does not look comfortable at all. Well, and as soon as I say that, he walks the string and gets a double electric.
Cool. Oh, and look at the damage on that combo there. But you can never count out Captain Hot Dog.
Nice counter hit 1-1, and we were talking about that before. Just getting hit with these strings gets his back, and that's going to be a combo and potentially
death.
The round. Boop. KO.
That was great stuff there from Onigen. What an adjustment and what a capitalization for the combo damage. Fight. Hey. Oh, the cancel.
Oh, down 4-2 anyway, and that's a great option. And that's one of the few times we've seen Aeris go for a gimmick. Because you can just, you know, like pop kick something like that and get a full launch.
All right, Aeris with a down 2 into the commando roll. Uh-oh, big sweep while rising 4. Back 1-2 into the screw. What's he going to do with it?
Oh, drops the combo again. And once again, this time, getting him with the wild rising 4. And those are the gimmicks. He's playing really solid up to a chance for you to get hit with gimmicks. And you see he's typically sticking to those low moves because if he does electric, he'll go under.
Yeah, nice follow-up. Able to get the counter in 4-4-4 into the mix-up. Oh, and the tackle.
Get off of me, you weirdo. Oh, wow. Hits on the ground. Running two. Running to a game. Look at this pressure. Still gets hit on that last part of the
game. Oh, he doesn't know. He's getting hit by everything. And Aeris might be able to close it out here. What's he going to do? Goes for the mid.
Oh,
twice in a row.
Back
Aeris.
Three. And Aeris moves on to lose. Oh, that's cool. I'm just means I'm going to go in. He's like, oh, you want to go in? Looks like I'm going to be really turtle. So I want to see how Joy Fury deals with it. Nice.
Oh,
down 1-4.
Nice. Gets the counter hit on it, too.
Oh, nice. Whoa. Low parry.
Yeah, Aeris is ready for this. All right, nice. Gets him with the noggin.
Oh, debugger. Rage drive debugger right now. And it puts him back. Get your ass in this air, though.
All right, he's not going to kill, but it's going to be very close.
Down 4-1. And you saw how much range that had. Rage drive running.
Oh,
two.
And Aeris going to close it out here. Nice stuff. And that is the perfect situation to use it. The pressure there from the rage drive running 1+2 goes into a 50-50 and closes it out.
Oh, wow. Rising one right here from Joy Fury. Gets a nice hit. Nice extension. Going to get great wall carry. Position is going to be in his favor. Nice back dash right there.
Okay.
On hand, sir.
Nice. Caught him with the sidestep option there.
Oh, didn't let it rip this time. Nice wall rising one.
Good stuff here. Third option got hit. And Aeris been using that so much this entire day. And closing it out. Oh, man, he dropped it.
And another
back three.
Yeah.
Aeris two rounds to none right now. The beard is shining.
Shining beard.
Here we go. Follow up. Hits him with the down 4-1. Hits him with the 4-2. Look at this stuff. They're going back and forth, trading blows.
Oh, 1-2-1 counter hit again. And Aeris looking in full control right now before he gets counter hit. and a down four to take it.
Round four.
Nice, up 4-3, follow up into the down two.
Running cool.
And Harris right now with the aggression pushing towards
and
the wall.
And this is what I said before. He sees that Joy Fury is definitely more on the turtle side of this. Uh-oh. So he's going to go in.
Man, Harris is doing so well in this matchup so far. Oh, debug, great drive.
And this is what brought Joy Fury back last time.
Nice block there, but out of range to punish. And here comes Harris.
Oh, nice break. And down four to take it, Harris. I had other songs already.
You said you had 9 songs.
Dude, yeah, I had 9 songs, even though we were supposed to have 5. All right, let's go.
Okay. Into the tombstone.
Oh, what do you want on your pizza?
Smell it. Follow up. What's going to happen?
Down 4-1.
Second hit.
Oh, backswing blow. This is going to give Harris a nice little standing, and as well as great wall carry. Gets that hard spike and the stomp, and he's back in it.
What a combo and what a mix-up there. Harris had a counter hit opportunity there.
And tries to go for 2 throws. Joy Fury just ready for it, though. Oh, wow, and not blocking the other ends of these strings, and is definitely catching up with him. And we saw him do this multiple times. We saw him do it versus Onigen as well.
Yeah, maybe just a lack of familiarity of Dragunov in the East. I don't know what's happening, but Harris is getting the third hit of everything to land.
Right, and the mileage he's getting is just ridiculous. Wow, nice sidestep right there.
Okay, punish.
Oh, down 4-2, finds the hit. It looks like Harris is trying to get out of the way.
There's a mix-up. What's he going
to
go for?
Tries
I have a feeling he's going to debug. Never mind. Goes for the down 4-2 launch.
Harris. Harris getting a little antsy right there. Get up kick, gets punished. On the wall. Lots of damage. Down back 1, and that is a mid, sir.
All right, so Joey Fury back on the scoreboard. Showing signs of life here. Trying to keep Harris honest here. Nice low parry. Hey, going to push towards the wall. Is he going to get it? Just short of it.
Oh, down 4. Oh, down back 1, and he is just picking Harris apart now. And you see him. Nice backswing blow.
Harris has been landing that so much, but now mix-ups at the wall. Be careful. Very scary situation to be in.
And Joy Fury's throw breaking has gotten so much better. Yo, get up, tackle. Get off of me. I'm a machine. I don't do that. Down 4-1.
Oh, big sweep.
Down back 3 right there. I'm sorry, down back 4.
Both players looking for that spacing, that opening.
Oh, deep.
What a big
bugger.
Risk there. Man, not even the safe version. Didn't even have the rage drive, but still went for it. All right, counter 1-2-1. Follow up into the low parry fake. Oh, he doesn't know it. Harris going in with the strings.
And you know Boko is paying a lot of attention right now.
Okay, follow up, what's going to happen?
Oh, wow.
Nice, threading the needle, but unable to get it.
And this is what I was talking about. Harris definitely able to turn it on and off at will, but Joey Fury takes the last three. All right, let's see what's going to change here. Joey Fury definitely played more in the middle ground. Gets sidestepped, though, into this wild rising two. Going to break the floor here from Harris. Nice damage on the wall. Blocks the sub wild rising four to punish. Backswing blow. Floor break again, and we saw Harris play like this before. Every time he gets to stage, he wants to break as many floors as possible. Oh, the doo-doo just sitting on his chest,
and he
taking
got
a nice warm dump.
Hold my legs, please. Hold my legs. Oh, caught him out of the error. Here we go. Oh, man. Harris right now, he's feeling himself. He's switching it up. Oh, my. Okay,
to
gotta respect
him. Yeah. And no floor break there from Joy Fury. Oh, wow. Let's it rip this time. But this time he blocks it. What do you want on your pizza? Harris likes jalapenos. There you go.
And a follow-up, a hit in the back of the face. Oh, he had an opportunity there, but here comes. He went for the fake low parry again.
Committing to the parry, and Joy Fury is turning it on now. Like I said before, normally a very defensive player. Yo, it trades with the power crush. Down back 1.
Hey, nice down 2 again. Down 4-2. Good stuff from Joey Fury. Now pushing towards the wall. He should be able to get it. Never mind. It's far.
Oh, hops over.
He thinks he's Akuma. Neutral jump.
Oh, drops the wild standing 4. Gets the wall split.
Oh, no. Harris, what is he doing? He went for a throw there.
Hits the low parry
Dang,
this time.
He's so sick. I can't believe he went for that.
Of course, Dragunov. Now since they removed Yoshimitsu, is the only person with the low parry like that.
Well, now you're from back turn as well.
Oh, yeah.
But,
yeah.
I mean, come on. Ooh.
Down 4-2. It's air to air, so no combo. Down back.
Air still has a chance here, but 4-4 looks.
Oh, wow. And they are playing touch and go game right now.
Yeah. Definitely no flag football here. They are tackling.
Down two, nice low parry. He's going to get great wall carry. And we've seen Joey Fury do some great things in the corner.
Uh-oh. Does he know it? He doesn't. Harris going in. Got him out of there. Not able to get a big combo, but we'll see what's going to happen.
Oh, nice throw range on the two right there.
Oh, my gosh. He let it rip. 4-1 pursuit.
Full crouch down 4-3 to take it. And Harris, I need to find out what this instrument is called. It's like cups, like wooden cups. Anyways.
They got taiko drums, and then they got this other stuff going on. It's like, I don't know, man. It's crazy.
Oh, nice.
Man, Harris right now working on a huge lead here in this opening round.
Up 4-3.
Running two. Here's the pressure. Oh, into the stop. One more mix-up could do it.
Down back. One blocked and punished with the full crouch down 4-4. Nice.
And Harris moving on. So far. Big counter hit 4-2 there. Talk to the hand. Look at the
life lead
right
this time. Gets to 4-12. Not dropping it this time. Nice wall carry. Runs up for the down two. Domino spike.
Oh wow. And it missed the second hit. Joey Fury able to get the down 4-2. It looks like he might close it out here.
Oh, run up, down back. One, the repeater.
Round three. Fight.
Look at the size of Jack's boot.
I know,
holy
right?
Crap. Okay, gets the combo. Here comes Harris. Oh, back to the other side.
Oh, wow, this combo actually put him in a bad position. Goes for that two. Even though he breaks, it gives him the wall position back. 1-2-1, that's going to hurt a lot.
You got the counter hit on it, too.
Down four. And we saw this before. Joey Fury definitely likes to use that Rage Drive debugger, so he needs to be really careful. Going to get a combo here. I will not burn. There you go. One. And now he's back in the game. Down 4-4 to take it. And Harris is on set point to move on.
Harris has a chance
versus
here.
Versus Poco.
We'll see what happens. Oh, down 4-2. Scopes him out of the air. Here's a big combo from Joey Fury.
Oh, get up.
Hit him with a counter hit, wake up kick. Follow up. Goes for the spike. Unable to get it, but doesn't matter. Resets the situation. Here comes Harris.
And goes for the easier combo. Hasn't been too confident with getting that while standing four after that second counter hit.
Harris almost enraged. Joey Fury now.
Commando roll.
He got hit by it raw.
Second hit. And Joey Fury is not out of this yet. Yo, I thought this was donezo. Harris runs into the second hit of the Rage Drive.
Oh, man, this match is getting intense. Harris could take it all here, or Joey Fury might be able to tie it up. We'll see. Not the tenth ring.
Oh, nice block and punish. Here comes Joey Fury. Hits him out of the backswing blow.
Harris does have rage here. He has an opportunity. Oh, man. You got to be aware. Oh, he could close it out here. This might be it. That's going to be it, and Harris takes it.
And Harris moves on, and he's going to be fighting Poco. Calls on being able to stop him. First match grand finals. Let's get it. Down two to get under it, and Poco committing to the duck, and Harris just goes right into a string. Oh, gets under it. Harris has some stress.
Has he been waiting to unleash this the whole time?
Using a lot of those low profiling moves to get under Akuma, much like Street Fighter.
He's going to get the, gets the punish, but not getting a full launch, of course.
Oh, nice to get out of there. He clips the power crush. Akuma.
What's he going to do? Oh, the neutral jump. And of course, Harris with the low parry. He should be able to
go
take
Rage
it.
Art. Going to Rage Art. Wow, he never goes into Rage Art, but takes the first round anyway. And look at Infiltration.
Infiltration just told him, do what I taught you with Akuma. Do the move. Oh!
Oh, wow.
The disrespect there.
Oh!
Wow, that was a free launch there from Harris. Downstairs, what's he going to do?
Nice. Down two again.
Oh! He almost let it rip. All it's right. going to be big
Runs
damage.
Meter this time. Probably going to get a wall. Nope. Probably going to get a wall break. Nice, using that crawl away.
Okay.
That's so smart to use his crawl away because he has a unique getup. Yep. Wait and crawl away or towards the opponent and potentially get a tackle. Oh. Oh, right. Down 4-2. No.
You should just go for 4-1.
Yeah.
Oh, he blocked that. I can't believe he blocked that. Oh, no, he didn't. Oh, Harris is going in. There's meter, too. He's going to have to be careful.
Oh.
Push towards the wall. Here's a big mix-up.
Oh. Staying crouched. Actually, really smart. Going to be able to get a small combo. Oh.
Well, that's unfortunate.
Oh, gets the sweep. Hit up three of his own. Oh, up four. Four gets the hit. Oh, stomp. No sandals, baby. He's wearing sandals. You see these boots? They're made for walking. Oh, down four. Oh, nice. Oh, wow, nice. Tries to make him respected, but he doesn't. And Puko doesn't burn the meter. He has four everything. Wake up. Gets the DP, and he's still not spinning meter. Blocks the low. Oh, my God. And while rising two, and he is still in this first match, Eris in full control, but even still.
Yeah, Puko making a huge comeback right now. We'll see how this works out, but either one's a match. Oh, it goes to the jump Tatsu. Doesn't get the full combo.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow. He caught him ducking.
Rising two goes right into the cancel time, so you'll still get hit by the end of it. All right,
see again, 1-0 right now for Puko. Oh, nice. Oh, got him.
Down two again. Oh, down four. 1-2 punisher. Yeah, you need to play that range. Never mind. 4-12.
Oh, he's nice. Walking. He's been watching that.
Yeah.
And if you guys are just tuning in, you're watching Tekken 7 Grand Finals here from Canada Cup. It's 1-0 in favor of Puko. Eris in the loser's bracket right now.
Needs to be really careful. He had a lot of chances to close it
out. Oh, he's going to catch him. Oh, Eris.
Yo,
what
the murderer? The murderer? He did it in the cupboard with the mallet. Ugh.
Now the crowd is hype for it. Round
two. Every time I see Dragunov Super, I just think of him doing like it's like somebody playing Clue. Anyways,
Who did it? Are you the guilty verdict? Oh. It was you, wasn't it? Oh, Eris is going to go in. And this is how you play against, oh my goodness. Never mind. He's playing Street Fighter versus a Tekken player.
It's not over.
Oh.
Finds that hit and committing to jumps at this point.
Yeah, jump ins work.
The only reason he's jumping in is because he feels like Eris is going to backdash to get out of there. So he wants to jump in to at least make him block. And that's why you saw that he wasn't committing to spending any of that meter.
Oh, he didn't get a launch. Oh, what a sidestep there from Eris.
Nice, he can stay with the tailspin. Oh.
Oh my goodness!
Yo,
that's gonna
demon?
Hit. It's not gonna kill though.
Eris enraged himself. I would have woke up and did Rage Art.
Oh.
I would have woke up and did Rage Art. I mean, that's why I'm not in the Grand Finals, but.
But I would have hit the Rage Art.
Right, back to trade. Oh, nice sidestep. Sidestep 2 actually a good move because it auto-tracks. So it auto-sidesteps. So.
Yeah, and also has a good opportunity to follow up afterwards with DP from Puko. Oh, here we go. And Eris still trying to stay alive. Backswing blow. Here's a big punish. Here we go. Dragunov has a chance.
He has a sliver of life right now. All right, and this time goes for the Rage Art.
This is going to do a lot of damage total. He's going to have one mix-up afterwards. I think he's going to go for a running, too. But
it was
we'll
the sailboat captain in the shower. Wow. Lots of damage.
Oh my goodness. God. Wake up low. Fight. Hey. Goes to the shoulder, of course. Still punished there.
And hey, you see Funko playing a lot more carefully this time around. Oh, judo. Get him right there in the nerve on the side of the neck, man. All right, off 33. And Puko committing a lot more to Ducky this time around, I'm noticing.
Oh, nice, backswing. Hey, follow up, what's he gonna do?
Oh, he's been dropping that all weekend.
I just almost threw my headset just now.
Oh, what up in the defense by Puko. Yo, he's looking like a lot more like a Tekken player now.
Yeah, he's definitely ducking at the right times against Dragunov's down two. And he definitely has reflexes. But right now, Eris is working on it. Hey, gets the float. Misses the back 1-2, but doesn't matter. Still holding that lead.
Back 2-1. Eris comes back.
And that could be the chili dog that he needed. The jump over. Oh, caught him out of the air.
Oh, gets the jump in. Just commits the 1-1, nothing crazy. Didn't use any meter and finishes the string. Poco takes the 1-2.
All right.
Oh, judo right on the side of the neck. Oh, down 2. Eris finishes up with a down 4. And you notice Poco was trying to get away because he knew what was going to happen. And now he has full meter, though, so he can definitely win a round or two just by saving.
Oh, what is he doing? But Poco just burning all that meter, not getting full damage out of it. Has an opportunity here, though. Running 3 into the mix-up. Burns him up.
And gets a little chip damage. Nice setup. Yo, look at that movement. Ice skating, even. We are on the snow stage.
Oh, he let it rip.
Oh, wow, not a combo.
Didn't get the dash cancel, that's why I didn't land. Oh, the dragon.
Of course.
And
of course he's
going to so
wake up and
can't
do that.
He did that. Get it clean there, too.
Set point right here. Eris needs this round to stay alive.
Uh-oh, he doesn't know the string. Oh, he just throws the Tatsu.
He just throws out Tatsu. Oh, Eris trying to hit buttons too close.
Oh, he has full meter too. He's going to have to be very careful. Eris is going to have to go in. Oh, no. This could be it. Never mind. Poco drops it.
Rage Art. You need to use your rage on Eris. It's the only way Rage Art. Oh, my God.
Low.
Rage Art this mother. Rage Art him.
Oh, no. Oh, and the punish. He blocked the 10th string. I like his idea there, but Poco able to take it.